Hello friends, welcome back to STM Tutorials. Myself Ajinkya and we are here to learn embedded system on STM32F103 controller. So let's begin. In this video, we will see our first mini project. The project is somewhat like password based security system. So here is the circuit diagram along with the STM controller. The keypad and LCD are interfaced with the STM controller. The keypad is interfaced with port B pins. And the LCD is interfaced with port A pins. We have also connected one LED to PC13 pin. To know more about the LCD and keypad interface, click on these videos. First, we will see how the system works. When we start the system, welcome is displayed on the first line of the LCD. After some time, LCD is cleared and enter password is displayed on the first line. We have to enter the password by pressing the number keys on the keypad. The number keys must be pressed after the blinking of the LED on PC13 pin. So we will enter the password. The correct password for the system is 12345. We can program it accordingly. We can change the password in the program. So let's enter the wrong password first and see what happens. So let's enter 4 1 2 3 4. After entering the wrong password, the system asks us to re-enter the password. So the password 41234 is not valid. After re-enter password is displayed on the LCD, the system waits for some time and it again asks the user to enter the password. So let's enter the correct password this time. So the correct password is 12345 and we can observe that each passkey is entered after the LED blink. After entering the password as 12345, the system welcomes us, so it grants us the access, that is, the password is correct. The system waits for some time and asks us to enter the password. So entering any passkey other than 12345 will deny us the access. So let's see the code. First we will see the main function. So here in the main function we have declared unsigned character var1. This variable var1 will be used to store the pressed key, or in other words, to read the pressed key. Fourth line, we have declared one array of ASCII characters. This array is a string to be displayed on the LCD. So we will display welcome on the LCD. The functions on line 6, 7 and 8 are the controller configuration functions. These include HAL initialization, system clock initialization and GPIO initialization functions. On line 10 to 15, we have defined the initial state of the GPIO pins. GPIO A is connected to LCD and GPIO B is connected to keypad. So we have initialized these pins accordingly. On line 17, we have LCD initialization function. On line 18, we have LCD string function. The LCD string function is used to display the string on the LCD. On line 19, we have a delay function. On line 20, we have the LCD function which instructs the LCD to move the cursor to first position on the first line of the LCD. On line 21, we have the LCD string function which displays the string enter password on the LCD. And on line 22, we again have LCD function which instructs the LCD to move the cursor on the second line first position. To know more about the LCD and keypad functions, click on the LCD interface and keypad interface videos. In while loop, GPIO write function on line number 25 and 29 blinks the LED connected to GPIO C. The key press function on line number 27 reads the key pressed on the keyboard and stores the value in variable var1. The dispassKey function is used to display the key pressed on the LCD. We will see these remaining functions in the next part. If you enjoy the video, click on like, share and subscribe. And don't forget to watch our other videos also. Thanks for watching the video. And don't forget to watch our basic electronics video linked above. We will see you in the next video.